So, very happy to be with all of you. We are discussing this topic, developing trust in relationships. Trust plays such a major role in our lives today that actually many times we do not understand how important is trust. So in the picture on the screen, there is a part which is visible to all of us, the tree, the branch, the trunk, the leaves, the fruits, and everything else. But below the ground is also many roots of the tree. One time we were hearing about redwood trees, and these redwood trees are often 600, 700 years old. And one very important quality of these redwood trees is the roots of these redwood trees do not go deep into the ground, but they spread laterally. And in a forest of redwood trees, maybe a forest of 200, 300 trees, it's very interesting that every single tree has connection with every other tree through its roots. So the redwood tree is also a very amazing tree that the roots extend and they connect to other trees rather than go deeper into the ground and search for nutrition there. So any tree, mostly when we see a tree, when we say, "Mi ek vruksha baghitla, mi ek zhaad baghitla," actually what we are saying is we just saw the upper part of the tree and we totally missed the part of the tree that is below. But all of us can understand, for the tree to grow up, actually the roots have to grow inside the ground, either laterally, either deep, so that the tree continues to receive nutrition properly. And what if the roots don't grow properly? Then any small storm, or maybe even a person is standing below the tree and he leans against the tree, he pushes the tree a little bit, because the roots are not strong, the tree will suddenly fall down. So what is visible is many times the success of people. But what is invisible is the different factors that contributed to the success. If we meet somebody successful in life, that's why we are going to discuss this. So for any commercial exchange, anytime a patient pays fees, anytime the doctor pays EMI for the house or for his car loan or something, any commercial exchange, actually money is very important. But I can tell you, if the exchange is not commercial, if it is a non-commercial exchange, then trust is very important. Whether it is traveling, whether it is education, whether it is spirituality, or whether it is just purchasing milk from our milkman. So many times the milkman will say, "This milk is genuinely cow milk," and we just trust him. All of you, you can think about this. How many of us have actually gone to check whether the milk that is coming from our milkman, he gives us that milk in a packet or he gives us to us in a vessel, is that milk actually coming from a cow or a buffalo or some other animal in the morning? We don't know. We trust him. So whether it is our food, whether it is our milk, whether it is our water, whether it is every single thing that we do, if it is a non-commercial exchange, then trust is very important. So how many commercial exchanges do we have? We just have commercial exchanges for a small number of times. Actually, there are so many exchanges in our life that we have, which are totally non-commercial. Anytime we talk with our parents who don't stay with us, it's a non-commercial exchange. We tell them what is going on. Probably some of you have Ganpati at your home. So then today was Ananta Chaturdashi. So maybe you did Visarjan. So then you call up and then you say, "Aaj Visarjan kela Ganpatinsa." Any talk that we do, if you see, the kind of importance that we have given to money is totally disproportionate. Why? Because money is important for commercial exchanges. But in a day, how many commercial exchanges we have? You can yourself think, in today's day, how many commercial exchanges you had? Whereas most of our exchanges in life genuinely are non-commercial. and the currency for that is trust. So whether it is large scale networking, people are tying up with people in another city, or sometimes, you know, in cities especially, the team in today's COVID times is not reporting to the office. So somebody stays in one part of the city, another person stays in another part of the city. Sometimes meetings are happening today on online media like Zoom. So very important decisions pre-COVID were taken only in a physical meeting. But COVID has changed all that. And in COVID times, many important decisions are taken online, in an online meeting. Can you imagine how important it is in modern times to have good trust amongst people? Because greater the size of the networking, greater is the facilitation of meetings, important decisions, or the working of a company, the working of a hospital. The more it is happening online, lesser is the person-to-person interaction. And this is not decided by you or me. This is decided by the situation or the circumstances. So how important it is for all of us to invest in trust building. Because tomorrow some another pandemic can come, and again we will be locked up in our own homes, and I cannot meet anybody. At that time, what will matter is, do I have a trustworthy relationship with somebody? So whether it is a large-scale networking, or it could be a small-scale networking in the sense, a small family unit, mother and father, daughter and son, wife and husband. Even if it is two people staying together, and if they do not have trust on each other, every single time, if in a relationship we have to say, I'm speaking the truth. अरे मी खरं बोलतोय, माझ्यावर विश्वास ठेव, एवढं संशय करू नको. If we have to speak like this repeatedly, then we should understand that this relationship is not very strong in terms of trust. And we need to invest in trust building in this relationship. So whether it is a big corporation or it is a small family, imagine the child comes home and he brings his report card and it says that he has got good marks. But the father does not have trust. Then the father will say, kharas tula milale ka? Did you really get these marks? And the child feels, what are you saying? What do you mean? I honestly got these marks, and don't you have trust on me? Don't you believe that I can get these good marks? So in this way, actually, if there is no trust, then that relationship won't last long. Even if it is a child-parent relationship, even if it is a spouse-spouse relationship. So trust is very important. So lesson number one for all of us is, money is the currency of transaction and trust is the currency of interaction. Anytime we interact with anybody in life, please remember, it is not just the words that we speak. It is not just the clothes that we wear. It is not just the car in which we are traveling. Actually, what matters for an honest exchange is the trust that we can build in that exchange, in that interaction. Sometimes, you know, we meet some people whom we had spent a lot of time many years back. But now we may not be able to spend much time with each other. And that is the time when that old investment of trust comes handy. Businessmen, true businessmen, those who have been doing business for a long, long time, if you check with them, they will tell you, paisa aaj hai, kal nahi hai, lekin vishwas hona chahiye. So many businessmen, they operate in the market based on trust. They do not operate on the basis of money. If one businessman calls up another businessman and says, mere naam se itna paisa de do, if he's a trustworthy person, that money will be transferred. Recently, I was talking with a Marwadi person, and he stays in another part of the country outside Maharashtra, and he wanted to send some donation. And when he wanted to send some donation, I asked him, so how will you send? because he was saying that he'll send it very fast. So then I said, but this requires a lot of time to get deposited in the bank. Then he says, no, I will send that money through another system. And then he said, he knows some businessmen in that part of the country and he will give that money to those people. And those people will phone somebody in Bombay. And when they phone somebody in Bombay, there is so much trust in those communities that this person in Bombay, although has no contact with that person in another part of the country, can come and share, you know, the amount. So it's very interesting how there are so many things that are happening in this country just based on trust. Now, sometimes when we go to a circus, we are very much impressed by these trapeze artists. Yes. So trapeze artist means they swing and somebody who's at the other end, he also swings, and mid-air, they catch each other's hands and then they make so many somersaults. Aisa upar niche karte hain. And then we really get impressed. And I remember when I was a child, when I went to a circus, I saw it for the first time and I was gasping for my breath. I was like that I was saying. And my father was saying, don't you understand? They are paid for this. They are highly experienced. They have done a lot of practice. But every time that person would leap in the air, and every time I saw that there was a risk, then I was thinking, oh, how can this happen like that? And then I saw that actually when they are doing all the somersaults in the air and they are doing all these things, there is a net below. So all of you who have seen this happening in circuses, you must have seen this, that they do a lot of amazing things. And hardly I have seen anybody becoming unsuccessful. But I have always seen that there is a protective net below. Similarly, my dear friends, actually in our life also, sometimes there are unhappy moments, sometimes there are happy moments, and sometimes we are just neutral. And we cannot predict what will happen in our lives. But in our life also, if there is a net of trust below, then all the ups and downs that are happening in our life, it will not hurt us, it will not trouble us, and we will go through it without any complaints. Why? Even if you fall, just like this person, even if he falls, he knows there is a net below, there is no problem, he can again do what he wants to. Similarly, in our life, if we have invested in trust building, जरी काही वर खाली झालं तरी पण आपल्याला माहिती आहे या व्यक्तीचा माझ्यावर विश्वास आहे आणि त्या विश्वासाच्या आधारावर हे नातं पुन्हा एकदा स्थापित करता येईल. सो दिस इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर अस. इफ दिस नेट इज नॉट देअर, थिंक अबाउट इट. इफ दिस नेट इज नॉट देअर, दिस पर्सन विल थिंक ट्वाइस बिफोर मेकिंग दॅट लीप इन द एअर. जस्ट बिकॉज ही नोज देर इज अ नेट, ही कॅन व्हेरी carelessly, he can make that leap in the air. Similarly, in our life also, many times there are situations where we need to take certain risks. I know of one doctor who is trying to settle into a new practice. And now that he's settling into a new practice, after 4 or 5 years of practicing in one place, there's a risk in front of him. But he knows his family members are with him and his friends are with him. So he's actually going through a major risk. But just based on trust, it is not hurting him so much. But I was just thinking, if there was no support from his family members, if there was no support from his friends in the form of trust, then it would have been very difficult for him to make a decision. So the net of trust actually makes it safe for us to go through ups and downs of our life. So lesson number 2 for us is, the unpredictable ups and downs of life become acceptable when there is a net of trust below. And that's why trust is very important for us. It actually empowers us to take decisions in life. I'll tell you one story. One time, one couple, they came to meet me, and the wife was saying that everything is good about my husband. The only problem with my husband is he's very quick at passing comments. And she was saying, just recently he came back from his office around 8 o'clock. And that day, Mataji, this wife, she was really exhausted. She was really tired. and she could not arrange the home nicely. And when the husband came home, this was around 8 o'clock in the evening, very carelessly, he passed a very fast comment. And he said, "What do you do whole day? You don't have any work whole day. And you cannot even arrange the home properly." And the wife was already exhausted taking care of the kids, taking care of all the family members. And that day she just exploded. And she just said, "What do you mean? I don't have anything to do at home. Who is doing all the cooking? Who is maintaining the home? Who is taking care of your kids? Who is taking care of your parents?" And in that way, you know, there was a big explosion. So then because of that explosion, they came to meet me. And, you know, they wanted to come back to normal. So then the wife explained all this, how he's very quick to pass comments. And then the husband heard all this and the husband also felt, okay, he made a mistake. And then he said, okay, I'm sorry. And when I looked at Mataji, then Mataji said, "Actually, just look at the speed at which he said sorry." I started speaking my side of the story, and immediately he's saying sorry. You know what? I don't even trust his sorry. So there is such a big trust deficit in this relationship that already he has passed so many comments, already he has made such critical remarks, already the trust level is so low. Even if he says sorry, the word sorry seems to be like a hollow thing, and there is no feeling there, there is no substance there. And that's why the wife said, "Actually, I don't even trust this word sorry from him." And that day I understood that a lot of damage has been done. And because of this damage, this husband and wife relationship will take a long time to get repaired. So all of us in any relationship we have to make a net of trust, and that net of trust will allow us to go through difficulties in life, knowing very well whatever happens, people are there to help us, people are there to trust us. Okay, now a question for you to make it a little interactive. I have put a question on the screen. How do you build a stone tower like this? It is made up of stones. So anybody would like to unmute and tell me, you can let me know.
Good evening, Guruji.
Yes.
Good evening, Guruji.
Yeah, I'm able to hear you. Good evening.
First, we need to make a plan.
Yes.
And then collect the substances which are required for it.
Yes.
And people also.
Yes. So I'm just asking you a question. After the plan is ready and after the people are ready, how long will it take to build this stone tower? Roughly?
Depends on the speed.
Okay, no problem. If the people are skilled, maybe 6 months or something, you know, they're putting all these stones one on top of each other, and they are not even like bricks. Bricks are of the same size, so it looks very uniform. Some of the stones are big in size, some of the stones are small in size. So it is going to be a little bit more difficult than building a brick tower, is it not?
Yes.
Okay. So now another question, that how do you destroy a stone tower like this?
By losing it.
Yes.
Bombing. So,
yeah. So now one interesting thing is, to build that stone tower, you took some time to answer. And you were saying, well, it's a difficult task. We have to make a plan. And we need to have proper people. And it is going to be a tough task because the stones are not similar to each other. But as soon as I said, how do you destroy a stone tower? The answers came very fast. Yes, the answers came very fast, that you dismantle one of the stones or you bomb this tower. So what can we learn from this? Any lesson to be learned from this?
It takes long time.
Yeah, it takes long time to build something and it takes very less time to dismantle it. So one interesting thing is, if any stone, you know, the big stone at the bottom of the stone tower, somehow you are able to remove it by hitting it or using a tool or using a hammer or something, then because this stone tower is not made up of similar bricks, it is uneven. So one or two stones you remove from the bottom and there is a high probability that this entire stone tower can come crashing down. And another lesson, as you mentioned, is it takes a lot of time to build a strong structure like a stone tower. It is definitely more stronger than a brick tower. But it takes a lot of time to build because it is a strong structure. But even this strong structure, if you want to destroy it, it can be done very fast. Similarly, all of my friends who are attending the seminar, trust is like this stone tower. Actually, trust is a very strong emotion. Trust is a very long-standing emotion. If you have trust on somebody, a lot of ups and downs can be undergone, just like we mentioned in lesson number 2. But just like this stone tower, however strong it is and however long it takes to build it, it can be dismantled fast. Similarly, to dismantle trust is also very fast. If there is a major doubt, if there is a major suspicion, or we promised something to somebody and intentionally or unintentionally we did not do it, and we could not even give a good reason to the other person why we could not do it, then I can tell you this huge strong tower of trust that we built can come crashing down. So please remember this, that trust takes a lot of time to build, but to destroy trust is actually very fast. Okay, now the third question, which is very important. Once destroyed, if this tower is destroyed and all the stones are at the bottom, how do you rebuild a stone tower like this? Anybody from you would like to unmute and speak?
Clean the debris first.
Yeah, but you know what? For a stone tower like this, probably, you know, that workers or the people, when you bring them and you tell them, now we need to rebuild, they're going to ask you a question. They're going to say, 6 months back, we underwent all the hard work of building this tower. And I don't know why you destroyed the tower, why you could not protect the tower. And now you want us to again rebuild the tower. You want again to do all this. So please tell me, you know, first time I was mentioning that you need skilled people, you know, not that any person can build a stone tower because it's made up of unique bricks. They are not similar to each other. So that skilled labor is not usually very easily available. So for some reason, this stone tower was destroyed. And now you call them and tell them, chalo, main aapko wapis se paisa deta hoon. But you rebuild the stone tower. What do you feel will be our experience with those people?
They won't be happy to build it again.
They won't be happy to build it. There will be reluctance from them. They will ask you 100 questions why we need to build it again. And they will ask you 1,000 questions why it got destroyed in the first place. We made it in such a nice way. We put in a lot of hard work. And how did it get destroyed, first of all? Is it not? So similarly, trust takes a lot of time to build. And if you destroy trust, it comes crashing down. And now if you want to rebuild trust, it is going to be 100 times more difficult than building the original tower, because there are going to be 1,000 questions. We put so much energy into building this stone tower of trust. And how did you destroy it? And why were you careless? And why you did not take care of this stone tower of trust? So please remember that you many times only get a single chance to build trust. Many times, unless people are extremely mature, and that is a big rarity in today's times, unless people are extremely mature, you may not get a second chance to rebuild the stone tower of trust. So we have to be very careful. So lesson number 3 is, trust is like ice. takes a lot of time to form, but takes almost no time to melt. Fridge मध्ये आईस्क्रीम जर बनवायचं असेल 6-7 तास लागतात. आणि त्या आईस्क्रीमला तोंडात जर ठेवलं किंवा इवन एका कपमध्ये जरी ठेवलं 5 मिनिटांमध्ये ते आईस्क्रीम पूर्णपणे वितळलेलं असतं. सो ट्रस्ट इज ऑल्सो लाईक दिस, ऍक्च्युली इट टेक्स लॉट ऑफ टाइम टू फॉर्म बट इट टेक्स ऑलमोस्ट नो टाइम टू मेल्ट. सो प्लीज बी केअरफुल विथ युअर नियर अँड डिअर वन्स. वन वर्ड स्पोकन केअरलेसली, वन जेस्चर विथ युअर आईज डन केअरलेसली, and it can actually destroy. This is a challenge for all of us in modern times, because most of us are doing online communication now. It is very difficult to speak and call and phone and meet and actually, you know, do what is important. Less time and more to do. And actually in the beginning, you know, it gives you some sense of accomplishment. In less time, I can do so much. I can send a message and get this done. And I can send an email and get this done. But in this whole thing, please remember that sometimes there is a lot of miscommunication that happens in text messages. There's a lot of miscommunication that happens in email exchange. And there is actually no substitute to personally meeting people. So if somebody wants to meet you, don't say, can we discuss it on email? Can we discuss it on text messaging? If somebody wants to meet you, we have to find time for meeting people. But yes, if it is passing of certain information, there is no discussion to be had. You are just going to tell, do this like this, and they will do it. Then you don't need to call people. There you can use written communication and get things done fast. But where genuine people are involved, and where some discussion needs to happen, and where some decision making has to be done, it will be extremely important to do it in the form of a personal discussion to avoid the ill effects of written communication. And that's why, please do not allow the stone tower of trust, even one stone, to come out. Because as soon as one stone comes out, that whole tower becomes little unstable. Second stone comes out, that stone tower starts shaking. And the third stone comes out, that stone tower of 300 stones will come crashing down. So we have to be very careful with the stone tower of trust. Okay. Now we have heard this many times, as you sow, so shall you reap. And all of us know, if we sow a mango seed, then we get a mango tree. If you sow a neem seed, and then you get a neem tree. All of us know this. There is a story from the life of Alexander the Great. Today morning also we spoke one story from Alexander the Great, but this is a nice story. When he was in India and he was suffering, he caught a disease, and he did not have proper medicine, because all his close physicians, all his close doctors were not from India, and he only trusted people from his original country, Greece. So one of his closest doctors was Philip, and some close, army commanders of Alexander, they did not like this Philip and the kind of relationship that he had with Alexander. So politics means you create distrust. Politics means you poison somebody's ears. So what they did was, they told Alexander that this Philip is actually bribed by some king, and he does not give you medicine to recover. Actually, he is giving you poison to die fast. And, you know, he received a letter like this. And it is at that time that Alexander, there was some medicine to be taken, and this Philip came with that medicine to give. So Philip gave Alexander the medicine to drink, and Alexander gave Philip the letter that had come to him from some people alleging that Philip was actually a spy, and Philip had been bribed, and instead of giving medicine, Philip was actually giving him poison. So it was very interesting that they just exchanged. And Philip is reading the letter that was written to Alexander saying, Philip is a spy, Philip is giving poison, Philip has been bribed, like that. But Philip was actually a nice person. He was not bribed. And as he's reading the letter, he can see Alexander, that even though Alexander has read the letter, the medicine that Philip had brought that day, Alexander was taking the medicine. So now I'm asking all of you a question. If you are Philip and there has been an allegation made against you, and that letter you can read and the words of poison you can read, and as you are reading the words of poison, you are seeing that the person to whom that letter was given is actually trusting you. That person has put his trust on you, and as you are reading the letter, he is taking the poison. Actually, it's not poison, actually it is medicine. How much Alexander had trust on Philip? And now I'm going to ask you a question. If you are Philip and you are seeing Alexander taking the medicine that you gave, even though he has received his letter, what will happen to you? What is happening in your heart? Can you unmute and tell me? Yes, anybody like to unmute and tell me?
Will be overwhelmed.
Actually, it will touch our heart. We will be overwhelmed and we will say, from today onwards, I can do anything for this person. He has put so much trust in me. I am going to do anything for this person. Is it not? So sometimes when we, you know, follow our heart and when we trust somebody, it's a risk. But anything good in life can come in our life only when we put a trust or we take that risk. So here, when we see that somebody is taking a risk and putting his or her trust in us, actually it conquers our heart. And from that day onwards, we are willing to do anything for this person. This is something that happened to also Vibhishan. Actually, Vibhishan, when he came, Lord Ramchandra asked some of his followers, should we accept him? And some of them said, Vibhishan is a brother of Ravan and we have come here to fight with him. How can you trust him? He is from the same race of Rakshasas. He will take all our secrets and give it to them. But what did Lord Ramchandra say? He said, no, if somebody has come to me for shelter, I cannot deny him shelter. And can you imagine what must have happened to Vibhishan? Vibhishan is a person who has been kicked out by Ravan. Actually, if you read Ramayana, then you will see how the son of Ravan, Indrajit, actually insulted Vibhishan more than Ravan insulted Vibhishan. Indrajit was calling him a spy. Indrajit was calling him a snake. And he's saying, if you are sitting in your home and you see a snake, you cannot keep quiet. You have to kill that snake. And Indrajit is saying, actually, Vibhishan is like a snake. And hearing all these poisonous words, a non-snake person, Vibhishan, could no longer tolerate it. He left it, took shelter of Ram, and Ram gave. From that day onwards, although Vibhishan was from that kind of a background, but Vibhishan was a sold-out servant of Ram. And if you remember the last battle, when Ram was shooting many arrows at Ravan, but Ravan, he was still surviving. He was not getting killed. And it is at that time that Vibhishan mentioned, actually, there is some nectar, Amrit, in the heart of Ravan. So you have to evaporate that nectar. If you keep shooting arrows, it will not work. And then Agastya Rishi had given Aditya Hriday Mantra. Aditya means the sun. So Lord Ramchandra chanted it Aditya Hriday Mantra and he put the energy of the sun at the tip of the arrow and he shot Ravan. And when the arrow touched Ravan's heart, then the intensity of the sun, the heat of the sun evaporated all the Amrit, evaporated all the nectar, and that is how Ravan was killed. And that secret was known only to Vibhishan. So if Vibhishan would not have been accepted, then it would have been another story. Yes. So all of us should remember, we may have very good trustworthy relationships with some person, but every interaction that we have with that person, our trust is recalibrated. You know what it means? It means I have met one person 100 times and these 100 times we had very high trust conversations. But 101st time when he meets me and I am not really focusing on the conversation, I'm not really talking properly in the conversation and I'm looking here and there and I'm basically ignoring him, that trust that was set at a very high scale, 100 times. In the 101st time, it has been recalibrated as very low. So human beings are not robots. Human beings are not machines. And many times we treat human beings like machines. Just like we put our phone for charging, and maybe in 1 hour, the phone gets charged. So that's predictable. But if somebody is morose, if somebody is feeling sad, and last time you gave that person 15 minutes of good advice, 15 minutes of inspiration, and that person got charged up, it is not necessary that this time also it will happen in 15 minutes. It can happen in 15 days. Because we do not know what kind of damage has happened to the person this time. We are assuming that just like a phone gets charged every day in 1 hour, this person will also get charged in maybe 10 minutes, 15 minutes, half an hour, something. No. Similarly, trust is recalibrated. So you can never say, this person trusts me and that's why I can misbehave with this person. या व्यक्तीचा माझ्यावर विश्वास आहे म्हणून मी या व्यक्तीसोबत कसंही वागू शकतो, कसंही बोलू शकतो. And that is the symbol, that is the expression of my trust. No, my dear friends, you are missing the point. The point is, if somebody puts his or her trust in you, you have to stand up to that trust in every single interaction, and you never allow familiarity breeds contempt principle. In our life, many times that is what happens. आपल्या जवळचे जे लोक आहेत त्यांना आपण दुर्लक्ष करतो आणि जे दूरचे लोक आहेत त्यांना खूप लक्ष देतो. And that is where we lose. So the more close you are to somebody, the more careful you must be with that person. And the more you are far away from somebody, even if there are some ups and downs, it is not a serious problem. But many times what we do is reverse. When we meet strangers, we are very nice gentlemen with them. And when we meet our home relatives or maybe our own family people, sometimes we are very rough in our interaction. So please make a note of this, that trust is recalibrated at every interaction. Actually, it is a lifelong investment. And people who are really trustworthy, you can observe that there is not a single interaction with them in which you felt that they do not have the quality of attracting your trust. In every single interaction, these people have that ability to behave in such a way that they can attract your trust. So to attract trust of people, we have to behave in a visible way that people want to invest their trust in us. If we do not behave visibly, if we do not talk audibly, and we just keep saying, "Maza man saaf hai, my heart is clean, please do not look at my words, please do not look at my body language, please do not look at my behavior," it won't stand the test of time. Probably once or twice, people will believe that our heart is clean and maybe we made a mistake. But then over a period of time, people will say, if really you have a clean heart, then why your words are very poisonous? Why your words are very strong? If really your heart is clean, then why your behavior is always insulting? Why your behavior is not encouraging and inspiring and motivating? So we have to be very careful with this. So lesson number 4, money invested results in money earned. If you don't invest any money, you won't get any money. You don't have a bank account, there is no increase in your savings. But you put 100 rupees in your bank account, you get 106. What if you put 1000 rupees in your bank account? You get 60. What if you put 1 lakh rupees in your bank account? You get 6000 rupees. So the more money you put in the bank, the more is your earnings. Is it not? Similarly, to actually earn trust, we have to invest trust. So Lord Ramchandra, he was unsure and he was taking a big risk in accepting Vibhishan. Alexander was taking a big risk in taking the bowl of medicine that Philip was giving to him. But because they invested that trust in somebody, actually they got it several times multiplied. The last thing which we want to discuss today is 3 characteristics that are very important to earn trust of a person. The first is competence. Imagine you want to perform some kind of a surgery on yourself. There is something that needs medical intervention. and you're searching for a good surgeon, what are you looking for in him? What if he's a very honest surgeon, he's never cheated, the whole town is talking, sabse acche surgeon hai, aur man ke ekdam saaf hai, they say, but what is his success rate in surgeries? And they say, actually, honestly, every time a patient has gone to him for surgery, most times he has not been successfully healthy. Sometimes he has lost his life. Sometimes there has been a permanent damage in that surgery and like that. So you say, ek minute. Let's go slow. I think I need a competent surgeon. So many times in life, when we need to get certain things done, you know, we will tell somebody, majasati he karshil ka. And that time we think that this person is looking for character, but actually that person is looking for competence. So for a surgery, a proper, trained, efficient, expert surgeon is required. Now, you may have 3 or 4 surgeons who are all of them very skilled and very expert. Then you may go for character. And then you may find out, what is the character of these people? And then some of them may have some rumors about them. And some of them, you know, they may say that this surgeon is an expert surgeon and his character is also very nice. So now you got a surgeon who is very skilled, who also has a very good character. Then you call him and want to get an appointment. You call him, he does not pick up his phone. You send him a message, there is no reply. You send him an email, there is no reply. You contact secretary. Secretary says, I have already passed on your message that your surgery is very important, but sir has not replied. How long will you wait? Expert surgeon, very nice surgeon. At heart, he's a very nice surgeon. Somehow he is not able to manage his schedule and your surgery is not getting scheduled and valuable time is passing by and it can be a very deadly decision for you if that surgery does not happen soon. How long will you wait? So finally, what actually matters in any relationship is competence, character, and also connectivity, or I can also put it in another word, availability. So if we are extremely competent and we are having very nice heart, but if we are not available for people, then trust cannot get formed. So I'll stop here and I'll share more points in this competence, character, and connectivity in part 2, which we'll very soon arrange. I'll stop here. Thank you very much for your patient listening. Based on the points that we discussed today, if anyone of you has any questions, then you can kindly unmute yourself and speak. Okay, since there are no questions, I am really thankful to all of you. And if anybody wants to share any point that you liked in today's class, then you can unmute and share some good point that you liked or any question that you have.
Haribol Prabhuji.
Yes.
Prabhuji, my mind pulled up. वो आपने जो एक पॉइंट बोला कि दैट वी इन्वेस्ट मोर टाइम इन लाइक मे बी लाइक जो द पीपल होम वी डोंट नो क्लोजली वी इन्वेस्ट अवर मोर टाइम इन विद दोज पीपल एंड जो हमारे फैमिली मेंबर्स हैं वी टेक देम फॉर ग्रांटेड एंड प्रोबेबली आई थिंक दैट्स अ नॉर्मल रूटीन कि बहुत सारी चीजें ऐसी डे टू डे लाइफ में होती हैं then we take it for granted, okay, these are the close ones, these are our parents or family member, they will understand, okay, I'm busy with some other stuff, and we invest our time with other things, probably like not very important. So that point was really, really very helpful. So
yeah,
at least I really need to change on that.
Yeah, every interaction is valuable. And if you're having regular interactions with people who are close to you, then give it more importance. Be very careful with people who are close to you. Sometimes a small word spoken out of context to somebody who does not know you will not hurt that person because anyways there is no relationship. Anyways there is not much contact with that person. But people who are close to you, people who are really caring for you, a single word
really caring
spoken out of context can really damage that relationship.
Yes, Mahaji, thank you.
Yeah.
Then I would like to mention. Can I speak?
Yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
मला खूप छान वाटलं की क्लोजनेस आणि त्याच्या तर त्याचा तिथे जास्त तुम्ही केअरफुल असलं पाहिजे.
You can earn on that trust for life on. But this one slide when you had put that trust is like recalibrated at every interaction. This was like completely opposite to what I used to think. So thank you for that important correction.
Yeah, when we make an investment in the bank, maybe we have 10 lakh rupees in the bank, we can withdraw only that much amount. If you try to withdraw 1 lakh rupees, you can do it only 10 times. And after that, when you want to withdraw, the bank will say, sorry, sir, but you don't have so much money in the account now. So similarly, to some extent, we may have invested our trust in a relationship, but the depletion happens very fast. That was my example, that trust is like ice.
Right.
To form eyes, it takes a lot of time, and that's why we feel अरे बनाने के लिए इतना समय लगा तो टूटने के लिए भी बहुत समय लगेगा. जी नहीं, बर्फ को पिघलने के लिए बहुत कम समय लगता है. So for ice to melt, it melts very fast. So we have to be very careful. You know, the refrigerator has to be really strong. The refrigerator cannot have any leaks. Otherwise, no ice gets formed, and whatever ice is formed can easily melt.
Right.
So next time we'll meet and we'll discuss more on competence, character, and availability or connectivity. Till then, thank you very much. Grateful to all of you for giving me a chance to speak on this important topic. And please don't miss part 2. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Jai Shri Krishna Bhagwan ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Ananta Koti Vaishnavrinda ki jai.
Jai.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna.